who are also such a clean team, if they can incorporate some clean plays here in some of these games, but also keep the magic alive, then they maybe have a shot.
Maybe they do. I mean, some magic for Misfits. I mean, we saw it last week.
Why do we keep bringing back magic?
Because you can't explain it if you refuse to split push properly and you go for fight. It's better than animal style.
It is. Yeah. I like magic more than definitely. So Misfits, game one, they were on blue side. They banned Shen, Rengar, Malzahar. Rengar is still left open right now. Did not work for Kakao in the last game. Did not really work for Kakao that often this split. But Elise and Lee Sin will keep getting removed by the Unicorns a lot because they have no reason to change.
Elise ban.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't say that. Repo is now going to predict Elise ban.
Yeah, Elise is going to be banned out by the Unicorns here, leaving Misfits with a tough choice for what they first pick.
First pick Graves again is definitely an option. Also with the Camille ban, they don't want it to go over to Unicorns a lot on the other side. Let's see if they change anything up in their last ban, but I still think Graves is the most likely first
They're
pick.
They're taking quite a while here that I'm getting worried about my prediction.
Well, let's see if Krepo was wrong.
Hiding the tension right now as Tekken's tick down for Unicorns of Love.
Whoa,
and surprise,
he got
surprise.
It! Profit! Bling!
All right. What's the first pick, though? Is this going to be the Graves again for Kakao?
I personally think that he would go Rengar.
I personally would like to see Graves. I think... The Rengar, it's just such a hit and miss champion for him, but Unicorns of Love can get the Rumble again. They can still get the Graves for
Next
Xerxes.
Next big Rumble.
It is.
They're going to flex this.
Just take the Graves and put it top lane.
They're going to flex this Rumble harder than with the official's biceps right now.
I'm not flexing. Really weird.
So it's going to be top lane for sure then.
Whoa, Diana. No, he almost did every time. I don't know the story. I know he was saying.
Settle down. LeBlanc's up and it's going to be locked for Exile.
Okay, that's fair as well. So now we got to see maybe the Corki again for Pauvivo. I would like the Ryze coming in for him as a different counter pick to this LeBlanc. A champion he also picked up towards the end of the split.
Yeah, level 6 Ryze Rengar can truly shut down this mid lane. Very easy. Not much you can do there if you're Xerxes on the LeBlanc. But you're not Xerxes on LeBlanc.
You're not Xerxes on LeBlanc. It will be
Exile.
An interesting choice. Yeah. Last time they also picked LeBlanc on its side of Unicorns, they banned Twisted Fate in
That's
this
interesting.
Second rotation. Might do the same just to play it safe because you're 2-0. You don't have to change a whole lot.
Well, for Unicorns, things are definitely looking good, but Misfits, they might need to find a different strategy here. See who's sane.
If it's not Ryze or Corki now, then they also risk one of them getting removed, okay?
All right. Dash has been up since... Still the first pick phase.
So they basically want to play a similar composition where they're also fine maybe playing Orianna again in this Lulu Rengar comp, but they felt they needed more engage.
Oh.
They needed something to happen.
There's your flex.
Flex is gone.
Flex is gone.
Unless it's Grave support. Smoke screen. But
that would be a very trickery.
Sand in their
thing.
Eyes.
I think
where's your skill source now?
I think again this draft team from Unicorns is really good. Like they get the best pick in mid for Exile. Chachi was a monster last game on the Rumble and didn't really struggle against Fizz up top lane, also due to no help from the jungler. So there is still a possibility for Misfits to draft a Fizz in the next phase if it doesn't get banned away by the Unicorns, and then still take that Corki matchup or Ryze matchup against LeBlanc, and they actually get a lot of counter choices on blue side, which is very, very rare that blue side gets to counterpick both solo laners.
Mm-hmm. Misfits here, hopefully going to make use of their second ban. We see Varus out, Ashe picked, Caitlyn removed, or maybe they think it does play. The TF comes out again.
Again, it's... Why change it if you're up 2-0? This is the kind of pick you remove if you got to suddenly get rid of something after you lose one game. But clearly, some scouting here from the Unicorns of Love. We don't know if they're correct or if they're completely wrong. This can also be because they know Pauvivo. And he's been on this team. He played with Sheepy and Chachi and Hillisang.
It's quite a while ago.
It's a while ago, but like you never know if back then it used to be a pick for him against LeBlanc. They saw it maybe in solo
back
queue.
Then.
They saw it in solo queue a few times, and they feel like there's a chance. We can ask them after.
Unicorns definitely see something. The question is it the right thing to see? Unicorns have a pick here, so Samix, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. He's back on the Lucian.
Tough matchup.
Game 3.
Really tough matchup to play any Lucian plus support lane into Lulu Ashe. You will get poked to hell and back. But we need to see Kakao help this bot lane with pressure so they can actually start putting turret pressure.
Give me the Fizz again. It worked for most of the game for you. Kennen can also do fine up here. I just want to see again this winning matchup for Alfari, especially later on in the game. So Kennen is good enough for us.
Ooh, the Karma mid.
Ooh, it's Lulu mid.
No, it's Karma.
No. This is Lulu mid. Lulu mid against LeBlanc.
Karma mid against LeBlanc.
I'm saying Lulu mid.
Karma mid.
Hashtag Lulu mid or hashtag Karma mid.
Lulu mid is useless. Have you seen it?
But
Who's played it?
I've heard about it. I've heard about picking Lulu into LeBlanc mid.
Yeah, the official. I've heard about Orianna support as well, so I think Yuluzhang is going to play Orianna support.
Right, well, he's
gonna
hover it. We know he's
gonna
hover
it. It's gonna be one of them. All right. Back over to the Unicorns. Final pick here for them.
Wait, Ignar isn't a Karma player, though. Has he really played?
Yeah, everyone can play Karma. I can play Karma.
Yeah.
Come on. Lulu mid.
Keep it simple for Hillisang. The Thresh has been up. Looks like he might end up blocking the Wifesteal lane. A few seconds still ticking away. Not a huge amount of tankiness on the Unicorn side, but the Thresh will have to do. It's locked. And now we get to answer your questions, gentlemen.
Oh, no.
It's sitting there right now.
Yeah, it's a bait. They have until 20 seconds.
No. This is happening. The theory behind it is that the LeBlanc will not really have kill pressure on you. You get somewhat decent wave clear, and then you go to the mid to late game stages, and you just prevent LeBlanc from actually killing anyone. The damage isn't the greatest for Lulu mid. That's obviously the biggest problem, so it is still an odd one. But the Karma mid, I feel like Karma mid will just offer you almost nothing in this case here. It's still there for another 5 seconds.
This is now a dual cast.
This is the Misfits Megatrix you opted out. All right, a few more seconds. It looks like that's it. They're going to have the Lulu mid. So, Misfits trying one more thing, trying to get a win on the board. Remember, they cannot afford to lose a single game if they want to make the finals.
So, to bring out the Lulu mid, man, that's absolutely insane. Hussein, he's crazy.
Well,
Utter.
Hussein,
he's a mad lad.
Last week said to the players, remember, when you're down 0-2, remember a team called Cloud9.
Yeah, no, Farah told him, stop talking.
Maybe he says like, again, I don't know, guys. But backs against the wall, Misfits have shown that they can come back. But this is a horse of a different color. Can they take out the Unicorns and force a game 4? Or is it going to be the Unicorns of Love cruising to a 3-0 victory? We want to hear from you guys one more time. Hashtag MSF win. Or if you believe in magic, hashtag UOL win. We'll find out. Let's go onto the Rift. This is going to be a good one once again. Lulu mid. I have not seen that in a hell of a long time. And DeFicio's looking smug, Crepo's looking sad, but I bet this one's gonna be bloody. So let's find out who takes it. Game 3, Unicorns Misfits, let's go.
A live design team sitting in LA crying
again?
Right now.
Again?
After like, right, we nerfed this. We killed Lulu mid lane. It's not supposed to happen again.
The cycle of support Lulu into mid continues. The champ gets butchered every single time a mid laner picks it.
Now, there is a chance that it doesn't work, and then it was just a one-off, you know? We've definitely seen other picks being picked and suddenly work for one game.
Few combos you can do. Now that there's a bit of a delay on the snapback on the W, it's actually more likely that you get a successful polymorph on LeBlanc in mid. That is something you need to look for. You can obviously knock LeBlanc out of her distortion with the Wild Growth as well. You can Q efficiently with both angles, so you can get her in front of you and her distortion location at the same time. So these are all counterplay patterns that you can do into the LeBlanc matchup.
And you just have to remember that Lulu's damage in early to mid game is still very, very good. It is just late game, she doesn't offer that much in terms of damage, but she will offer so much utility still for your team. So they're gonna rely on Alfari, Kakao, and Hansama as the main damage dealers later. But early trades with like EQ, running offensive summoner as well, like you can surprise people.
And back when Lulu was meta in the mid lane rather, she was the strongest 1-6 laner with the Ignite. She would just push and poke you all over, and it was not very wholesome to play against her.
Well, it wasn't very funny, which is one of the reasons also it got toned down a little bit, because she just offered so much back then in terms of damage in early to mid game, plus then of course all the insane utility in the late game. And now Power People is starting with his E. A little help picks.
Help picks, yeah. They changed it though, so it's not really good as a damage ability. It's better to put it on yourself and poke. And here we see, this is a really tough matchup for Samux and Hillisang. They need to hook their way out of this one.
I was going to say, speaking of poke right now, that's starting off a little bit rough for them. So we'll see if these Misfits lanes are going to be enough to tango with what the Unicorns are bringing out.
Pavio will use the help picks though to try and get the Thunderlord's procs early on and then see if he can get an advantage. Now there is teleport on Exile. Important to note, when they are trading a lot in the early game, often you're trading the mana from the other player for your HP.
Yeah, and then you can obviously just teleport back to lane early. First teleport, the Vicious Law is okay if you use it to lane.
Yes.
Second one, you have to use on the side lane.
Unless you're really far down. Yeah. Or playing Kassadin. Or Kale.
Or Kale.
The Kale is fine too. Don't blind pick Kale though, guys.
All right, standard Graves Clear here. It looks like a bit of an invade, but it's been super common. Two camps into enemy buff, into then top lane gank right now, and we need to see the Misfits are ready for this because they know the Graves can be here because they're doing the exact same thing on the other side of the map.
Alfari's been bullied quite a lot this series.
Oh, still
Flash
hits.
For Flash is still going to follow through. Alfari is in trouble. No escapes. And that's going to be first blood. It goes to Xerxes.
Nice. Flash straight. And so went the Harpoon. And it still hit him on max range. This is a bit of a blunder from Alfari. He knew the gank could be coming. This was the only way he could die.
Exactly. But it really sucks for Misfits here because they were running with three pushing lanes. Kennen was going to try and push in the Rumble up top lane. Bot lane, we already talked about the matchup. And then this Lulu counter pick in mid. But now with that kill for Chachi,
they may just go for a second dive, do you think?
I mean, you're up 2-0. You already killed him once.
He's
why, got
not, no flash.
Why not tilt him more? He's on the edge. You can give him the push.
Just push him down. Kennen desperately pushing back, of course. Yeah, I mean, we just highlighted it. Because Chachi just goes for a nice flash E. Is that E flash? Can you E flash in Rumble? I don't think so.
No, a lot of the abilities with animation can, of course, be set up and then flashed.
Does right he have enough of animation? I don't know. Well, it doesn't matter. Somebody will tweet it at me and well,
see,
if you're wrong.
Never ask that question right. Openly, because then you admit you don't know. And I want to talk about Xerxes instead, because he's about to gain top lane again.
Talk to me about Blast Cones right now.
Yeah, yeah, wait for it. He's going to hit the Blast Cone.
There is a ward there, though, this time.
Hit the Blast Cone.
No. There we go.
Oh, he hit the Blast Cone.
Ganking the Rift Scuttler.
Poor Scuttler, never saw it coming.
Kakao didn't realize that he lost all his camp on top side. He now realized he lost all his camps on top side. And he's off to another kind of rough start here.
Where he stole all the camps on the right side.
Yeah, but it's just a problem for him that Xerxes has already pulled off successful gank and will now get Raptors as well. So Xerxes will show more in the early game. And Kakao needs that level 6 and he needs to use that first ulti correctly to get him back into this game.
Mad Kitty Cat, ready for the dash.
Okay. Xerxes, no flash.
Wait, Xerxes actually safe pathing around this. This is smart. I like this. Very few junglers would do this. In solo queue, you die here.
Anybody
in
the rookie, crowd, by the way.
In the crowd, everybody who jungles in this crowd would have been dead by now.
Yeah, they know it. Kakao is still coming in, but Xerxes, he's fine. He's full health right now, and it's just a token Krug contest.
And he just yields. He's like, you know what? I don't need these Krugs.
I already got the first blood, you know.
Oh, Chachi could be in trouble, though. That's a lot of minions, and Alfari just solos him.
So that is now really good for Misfits. Alfari here. As we said before, it was supposed to be like these three pushing lanes. He then got ganked and it looked kind of rough, but him just getting an honestly very free solo kill on Mr. Chachi. Well played by Alfari.
Oh, Heelsing's under pressure here.
Big mistake though.
Yep, throws the hook though. He brings Ignar right into him. Play back. They had a few autos, but Samix and Heelsing were taking quite a lot of damage as well.
So what's going to happen this game here is Kennen will always win the side lane push against Chachi. Chachi's job is to kind of join his team, like we saw in the last game. Kennen's job is to stay in that side lane for as long as possible.
Ooh,
with Lin trade here, you can see how hard it is for Exile. He jumps in.
Gets polymorph.
Polymorph instantly, so Power Weaver can actually return a lot of damage.
He missed even Q there, I think, Power. Now he's going in for Ignite.
Ignite!
But he's dead!
What a play! Oh, the Lulu mid lane
is back.
We said it. You don't respect the damage in the early game. Power Evil, he knows exactly how much damage he can deal on this champion, and he takes down Exile. Last game, he also solo killed him a few times.
Power definitely showing up here in the race for best German.
Mid laner, for sure. Taking it to his former team right now. Exile's having trouble. And
hotfix coming tomorrow. Lulu mid has been nerfed again.
I mean, it's also Power of Evil. You take a look at the damage he was dishing out last game. That was the game they lost. And at the end of it, it really turned around, but he was dunking on Exile in lane.
He was, completely. Destroying the lane, got the two early kills as well. So, trade, Exile goes in at first.
Look at the Q here, does it connect even? It does still connect.
Yeah. So Whimsy.
Gets ball off, two more autos.
And then Exile, he needs to just back away. Like, needs to just respect the fact that EQ from Power of Evil plus his summoner will kill him.
And he gets level 6 too, more base damage.
Can't flash away from that pix that's sitting on your back.
No, you technically can. It just chases you.
It will chase you, yeah. It will follow you. And then you can land the Q pretty easily.
Thanks for
either you flash when the Q is in the air, then you can flash, but it is difficult.
Cal wants to go in himself. He stopped up by the chains. Roars out.
Oh, Heelsang's mid again.
Yeah, let's see. Xerxes chasing through Power of Evil. Heelsang there as well, as you said. And that will be the end of that one. A little telegraphed.
And now Misfits, just like in the last game, are winning early on. Their lanes, they're pushing, they're getting kills. Both Kennen and the Lulu, their composition is in many ways built around countering LeBlanc. You're going to get Karma shields, you're going to get Lulu shields, Lulu's ulti. Exiles should not be able to carry a game like this on the LeBlanc. Mm-hmm. So with Misfits now getting ahead early on, it's looking very, very good for the next 10, 15 minutes for them.
But the Unicorns have already given a big hit to the economy of the Misfits, because with three pushing lanes, your jungler should be in a much better state. There's no way this Graves is supposed to get a gank off as he did. So in that way, the game is a lot closer than it maybe could have been, judging just on the draft.
And this is very important for both these teams. Remember, what's at stake here right now? Unicorns are one game away from making that finals appearance. It's huge for these guys who haven't made it in 2 years.
Yeah, and again, like these Misfits, Botsen, Hansama, and Ignar, they start well with the poke, but look at the CS, 68 versus 74 currently. That is more than acceptable for this matchup. Like, that is actually underplaying here from Ignar and Hansama's side, unless his turret is brutally low, but can't really see it. Give it a check on my screen. If I move the mouse,
yeah. There you go.
It's not brutally low. It's at like 65, 70% even. So honestly, Stamix and Hillisang have been playing losing matchups and evening out.
So far, so good for those guys. And I mean, that's not too bad when you're playing up against a really tough, really pokey lane. We saw the beginning of it. And it's critique that the analyst desk was able to leverage too, is saying, look, these guys, they're not doing enough. We were expecting them to step up. They're winning their lane, or they have winning lanes, but they're not winning their lanes hard enough.
Well, this game again with their composition, so good at actually countering certain parts of Unicorns. They definitely have chance also winning late game. It's not just purely early game. Don't get fooled by Lulu mid when it comes to late game scaling.
Especially the health picks on the Ashe is pretty disgusting.
It's going to be good. And obviously again, in a pure teamfight setting, if you compare top laners as well, the AD carry cannon or the on-hit cannon, it's not very good in specific teamfights. Rumble will be way better there, but Alfari will just have so much control in the side lane throughout the entire game that Misfits can use that to force numbers advantages before the fights happen. Hansama does have ulti.
There is a cool interaction though still, because the way Fnatic made Kennen work very often was the Shen. AD Kennen can go in and ulti and be a nuisance if he has somebody to protect him. Now instead of the Shen, they still have something similar in the Lulu to buy more time for Alfari to ramp up, and he's also playing an attack speed build where health picks obviously gets them bigger yields.
And yeah, always keep in mind that the AD carry cannon can build Hurricane early on, which helps a bit in fights. Top lane cannon will not early on go for Hurricane. Nah. Wit's End first, because you're playing against Rumble. Mm-hmm. The MR is extremely valuable for you. It does mean Xerxe will deal a lot of damage if he goes in for a gank against you, but it requires Xerxe to actually get around that lane unnoticed. Kakao is on top side. This is what we want to see the last game against Rumble. It's so easy to gank Rumble as Rengar, because it's so easy to get onto him. And now he's here with ulti.
But Chachi is already close enough to tower. He has flash. He doesn't need to use it. Kakao is looking for a dive here. Mini wave's not big enough, but Kakao's going the long way around. Let's see if they can find the wraparound here. Kakao's still looking. Chachi knows something's up, throws the equalizer, flashes back. Kakao is foiled. Alfari wants to finish the job. He flashes, he autos, he gets another, and they manage to make it work.
Mid lane getting pushed in right now by the Unicorns because Kakao is showing top lane. See, they're rushing down this top lane tower. They will get it. And the mid lane turret is getting defended right now by the Misfits. So this will be first tower for Misfits.
Yeah, Karma can help proxy the wave as well. You know, really good proxy wave clear with EQ on the minions from Power of Evil. This is a really great gank, and this is exactly what we are missing from Kakao in the last game.
Definitely so. Get to see how easy it is with these top lane ganks against the Rumble. And now Kakao and Alfari with the top lane tower. Mid lane is defended, as we said before. Hillisang is spotted as well. Overall, good start for Misfits. We saw the same good start last game. It didn't work for them when it came to closing out the game, which was an issue.
And now what's next? Obviously, they need to be mindful of the teleport on Vizichachi. They could go for a play on the bottom side, but Unicorns aggressively defending that, and they know they have teleport too. This is the reaction from Unicorns on that top lane play.
But Fari went straight towards the mid lane, so he can actually path down to bottom lane if needed, if they want to defend this tower, but they're just going to surrender it because they don't have any control on bot side. And try and trade maybe for a mid tower?
Slow push in mid.
No, they
don't have Alfari and Kakao there.
Yeah, I mean, they have arrow if they see Exile uses W. Right now, shoot it to the clone.
Hold up, power still dealing. There he goes, he's back.
Shoot,
cooldown here.
That's arrow.
It's on cooldown, it's on cooldown.
The arrow's on cooldown.
Oh.
It's on cooldown.
There's the arrow.
There you go.
It's in the pocket.
Yeah, he's waiting, hiding it.
But Samus is going to get a tower. All right, Unicorns.
Yeah, but that wasn't part of the arrow story.
No, different story.
So,
arrow got old after a few seasons, guys.
I think Misfits right there
The Fissure doesn't get that one.
Right? Giving up the bottom. I didn't actually hear what he said because I was already.
He doesn't listen to me either.
I was already like on this next point here, but. Trying to think with Misfits.
Now there it is. All right, nails Chachi in the face. He's got no flash. He's got no life. He gets an equalizer.
Misfits
off,
last game. They were too passive in the early game. They had to become something else, Pyra. Someone else. Another team to go in there. That is an Arrow reference right there. The Fissure.
Cool. You guys are very cool.
We're educating this
You're
guy.
Nice, awesome guys.
And they're getting a lot of turret pressure right now.
Yes.
Now the snowball is rolling here. What a good opening. Hansama finally finds that early aggression. Difference between the Ashe and the Varus, much easier to land that ultimate.
Oh, Exile wants to go in. Hansama's got shields. I mean, this guy is going to get protected for days. He's got a Lulu. He's got a Karma.
This is a game for Hansama to carry. Last time, when they played against Splice, they were down 2-0. Hansama played Kalista. Went 8-0 in that game. They bounced back, and they reverse swept Splice. That's why Trashy's on the analyst desk and not on stage right now. Can they do the same again? Like, it's a great start. They're winning their lanes, 4-1. This is a good Arrow. That's why he was saving it.
Yep.
He knew.
Also, it makes you wonder why Visichachi is in the mid lane with no flash. Overheating for the majority.
Oh, and we get to see Exile again with the proto build. That is what he prefers. A lot of the other guys with the Gunblade build on this LeBron queue.
Still part of the Hextech family, though.
It's okay, as long as you get a Hextech. Not a Rage Plate. It's not a Hextech either, so.
Yeah, I want to go back to your point about Chachi, though, because he has made a number of uncharacteristic mistakes this game. It's not something we saw from him in the previous games in the series, and that's a little bit odd.
Definitely. Like, his playstyle usually is play super aggressive and take him down in the grave with him. That doesn't excuse what's going on in this game. He's definitely traveling to the grave alone on this Rumble pick. But yeah, he recently picked it up. Maybe he's just testing the limits.
I mean, he was good last game on it. So I think Chachi, this time around, just got under pressure a lot more. And good flashing. But this is what we want to see from Misfits last game with ganking that Rumble with the Rengar. Rengar is so good at ganking these side lanes as well. Now we get to see a dive into bot lane.
Oh, Chachi, he's melting fast. But so is Alfari, and that tower is helping out. Chachi's gonna stay alive off the back of it. Flashes
he's
up
back.
To both those top laners.
Chachi's back in the game.
There we go. Unicorn's trying to punish in mid, but Misfits, they're bringing more friends to the party here. Hillisang is isolated, jumped on by Kakao. That's a big wild growth. He flashes, power gets the kill with picks.
Yeah, this utility Lulu is really paying off for the Misfits. Power Reveal involved in three kills already, putting so much pressure, really facilitating other members like Kakao, speed him up, wild growth, maybe helping out when they want to go for an Arrow, too.
That is such a Power of Evil style, too. It's been said so many times, this is the guy that wants to help the rest of his team. He doesn't play for the lane. He can dunk lanes, but he doesn't always play for that dominance, and it's showing up huge now. This tower is going down. Misfits are going to find number two for themselves at 15 minutes in.
Bot lane tower as well. Alfari, going to take that one down. I have a strong feeling we're going to get some more games in this series.
I think we will.
This very, very nice pick advantage.
And there he
Misfits.
Goes. He jinxed it again. Every single time.
Every single time. That's very true. But this Finger Man phase from Misfits deserves so much respect because they come in here third game, they have prepared this counter pick, they use it, they win the mid lane with it. Of course, Alfari getting another good matchup up top lane as well. That's what we said in Champs League. Like, Misfits on blue side got two counter picks for their solo laners, which is so rare. You see that because Unicorns early just said, we need Rumble and we need LeBlanc.
And that means it only generally works if your counter picks are kind of like pocket picks. Because if the same kick and ban plays out, then this won't happen. This Lulu will not get through and he can't help Kakao find this pick here.
My name is Power of Evil and my pocket pick is Lulu.
Yeah,
apparently.
There's a lot of those.
Yeah, probably actually has a lot of weird pocket picks.
No, because if you look at it, the whole reason two counter picks and blue side can happen is only if you lock in the strong rolls, first rotation within the three picks. And you only do that if you feel like you have uncounterpickable matchups. Like a Syndra with certain champions removed, maybe like a LeBlanc with the conventional counters removed.
Because that's always very interesting how if Unicorns of Love, if you go back to the pick and ban phase, if they've just gotten Rumble Graves, they could actually have saved the mid lane pick for the next one. And if it wasn't LeBlanc, you know, if LeBlanc was picked by Misfits, they have a counter pick right there for Exile. If LeBlanc isn't picked by Misfits, you can pick LeBlanc and ban traditional counters at least. Lulu could still have showed up, but there are different ways around to kind of make sure you can get more counter picks on red side.
But they just didn't want to lose LeBlanc. They felt it was an uncounterable pick.
Of course.
And now They've been told.
Now, we were here again, like, an hour ago, where Misfits had won this early game super hard. They're looking for more now. They're speeding up Kao.
Oh, there's the arrow.
That's Ooh. A goal.
Nearly goes through the side post, but Samix is the one it hits, and Ignar is only able to send out a Mantra Q. End of that for now, but Misfits still defend mid-tower.
Yeah, now we want to see how far he's... Replay this split pushing game.
Yeah, back to the side lane. Don't stay mid. Yeah,
you don't have to try and play 5-on-5, because that gives Mr. Chachi a chance to get back into this game.
Exile, he's looking for a chance to get right back on. Ooh,
the chains don't land at point blank.
And Ignar is still down to half health, but that could have been more.
Seems like we get a reset from Misfit's side, but Unicorns are staying around because this tower needs just a few hits. You can send in Samux and just land him out.
Yep.
Also Lantern yourself, that works too.
Sled Hill is saying tank a couple of shots, that's easy peasy. Unicorns get a little bit more gold in their pockets, but they're still down 2,000.
If you Lantern them out, you'll get some gold.
The classic support.
Support. I'll tank this turret, guys, don't mind me.
I need this.
Ah, share the local gold, my bad. Happens.
Well, so we get kind of Misfits back to base. They're now back on the map already, so this is actually really good in terms of them quickly being able to make a play, because they will get to push bot now, get to push mid lane as well.
What top do call
lane.
That?
We call it Tembo, but people don't like Tembo for some reason. It just means Misfits are first back on the map after the recall, so they get to push first, and they force Unicorn to now react and come down to this lane here and pick up these big waves that give suddenly Misfits entrance into the jungle. If there was a dragon alive, they could take the dragon.
The world is their oyster.
The map is open because of Tembo.
Unicorns trying to play off the back foot, but we have seen them succeed at that before. However, Misfits are the ones baiting a trap right now. Well, we'll see.
There is a control ward. Always check your brushes, guys. Refresh your pivot tables and check your brushes. Really important.
I don't think too many people are going to get that one.
Ooh, exile.
All right, and now
the arrow.
Oh, he looks like he's going in. He flashes.
Ooh, doesn't connect.
And misses.
Turning. Let's see if he's gonna get something here. No, gonna have to heal up. Chains, once again, there are a lot of missed skill shots.
I mean,
in
it's
this
just,
fight.
It's so good for Misfits because when they play 4v4, Unicorns will not have the damage without Mr. Chachi's Rumble ulti to kill anyone due to Karma and Lulu. And that also means they have the Kennen winning the side lane. So it just means Misfits are winning everywhere on the map by playing this 1-4 setup. And it's just so good for them.
And they're also preventing people from influencing that side lane, making it just a pure 1v1 between Alfari and Vizichashi, and eventually that will break. And he also has the vision control right now, but because of the fast pace or the tempo, call whatever you want, there's two deep wards next to Alfari, so he's protected. He cannot get surprised, which means he can play much more aggressive than he usually would be able to do. And that allows then, the Unicorns, they're drawing aggro to bot side, which means the Misfits can counter with aggro in top side. They can get Nasha control, set it up like they used to want to do every single game. They failed last game, they need to give it another shot.
20 minutes have elapsed in this game right now. Baron is live and on the map. It has been Unicorn's bread and butter, but we have seen some real close calls there. Unicorns are mobilizing, trying to establish some vision control in that area of the map.
Unicorns love, they know it's all about defending Baron at this point, because if you lose the Baron, you will lose all your out of turrets extremely quickly. So you can't really team fight without Chachi there anyway. Will it be a little bit easier for Misfits also to tank their Baron because they have these shields? Kakao with Ninja Tabi can even get more armor after he gets his first damage item fully completed. And then suddenly you can actually bait around this Baron quite a lot.
And there it is. Black Cleaver's up and out. Let's see what Kakao can now do. Unicorns careful not to overstep their bounds as they clear out some wards and take the Lantern Express out. Alfari still pushing on this bottom side. It's going to be a thorn in Unicorn's side.
They are playing pretty well on three lanes, all the Unicorns. And this is something where the Misfits comp struggles again. It's a clear 4-1 composition. It is not a 1-3-1 or a 1-1-3 comp. You definitely want both Ashe and Lulu in the mid game, in the mid lane.
But it's fine if you can then send up support and AD carry, yeah. Like in this case, to push out the lane and get it slow pushing.
But it makes moving around the map so slow, right?
It does. It definitely does. And it relies on having that minion wave in one lane and then the four members in the mid. But they get to push it out now, but it gives Unicorns love the mid lane control, so that means Alfari needs to back away in the bot lane because otherwise he might get ganked.
I would actually love to see a Banner of Command here for the Misfits. That can be their solution in the mid game on the side lane. Just push up against who's been holding it. It's been Vizichachi or Exile who's been clearing out a lot of these side lanes.
Do you want to trade it though for Locket?
Yes, I think you do.
They found Illusang. He's going to send the hook. It just brings power in, and Hansama with a second kill assisted by the rest of Misfits.
I think you can even consider building Banner on Power of Evil if you're still slotting into this utility role anyways.
Fair.
And you'd say, wait, we're on a clock. It's definitely debatable. Definitely cool aspect.
I think so. Cal wants blood. Found Xerxe. See if he can get some revenge from last time. No, that's the blowback. Xerxe's out. But Misfits, they're stacked around this bottom side, looking ready to get another Mountain Drake.
Again, they fight their way into the enemy jungle. They know it's more important to get deep right vision than deep left vision, because you need to protect that matchup from Alfari versus Visage. As long as he keeps that Rumble on lockdown, Misfits can play the rest of the map as slow as they want to. They are very rarely under pressure.
Speaking of slow, Power was chasing out Exile, turns back in. Still even for now, guns to go in. Oh, okay. Not recommended, as he gets Polymorph.
Yeah, delay polymorph is actually a projectile, so it is blockable by Wind Wall. Flying Frogs, apparently. Oh, Ignar is going for the Karma flank on Samix. He used the Blast Cone. He's looking for the root into Arrow, but it's still on cooldown, so root into So.
Mantra. Okay, they're going to invest a lot here. Exhaust.
Oh, Unicorns is on the way.
Down. Unicorns are incoming. This fight's a lot more than Misfits might have bargained for. Samix is going to have to flash away. And Alfari is getting the kill on that one. He turns the rest of the Unicorns back. Ignar's in trouble. This has gotten messy. Misfits incoming. Lantern pulling Xerxe out, but Chachi is left. Four dead, Alfari on a rampage kill. That is two for two.
Yeah, this is actually good for the Unicorns of Love to get a two for two here, because they are so far behind in terms of also the control on the map. All started with Ignar setting up a gank. If Misfits can get this tower, though, it goes in their favor.
Should be able to secure this one up. Slim lead for Misfits are trying to add to that gold. Hansam and Ignar are both down. Exile, he is not even going to hesitate. Finishes his back channel. Misfits, though, they've got the inner.
This is a problem when you're already behind. Even getting a 2v2 trade might mean you have to lose something right after, and therefore Misfits wins out. So it's just a setup on Samix, but this actually allows a very split-up fight for the Unicorns, where Lulu is not even close. She's near the blue buff at this point. And then Misfits' composition of protecting some of these carries certainly won't work, and Sama goes down.
Yeah, Fari buys enough time. He paths away from the Thresh 2, doesn't get hooked. Now there's a Baron being
started.
Blast Cone Baron, guys. No.
Oh,
you realize he can't dank it.
All right, so they see it, backing away. Nice try.
You go into the pit and then you realize nobody is really tanky enough, and Thresh, like, 3-man Blast Cone Barons are fun, unless there's a support and they're, like, hitting the Nashor for 48 damage at a time. It's like, I'm helping.
Yeah. Not the man you want to bring with you, unless you can lantern in someone else, but there was no one nearby for the side of Unicorns.
That loses a lot of tempo.
Well, it just means Misfits gets full control of it now, and we get this Baron bait we wanted to see in the last game. Misfits, you need to be able to execute if you want to try and get to the final. You can't fool around for another 5-6 minutes, like in the last game, and then end up losing members left and right.
Have to be decisive. Something that Hussein has been pretty outspoken of. His team still needs some of that to be fixed up. It's what they were saying when they were 0-2 down against Splice last week. Don't be afraid. Be decisive. We're seeing that out of Misfits, but can they keep it up?
There are a few lingering wards on the map that could potentially be used for Exile Teleport. Misfits fighting the Unicorns in their own brush. This is where they found a lot of success throughout the split.
That is the Unicorn
the Unicorn's brush.
I mean, both of them are Unicorn's brushes, right?
So Chachi's grouping now, and there's the engage.
Oh man, they get a big old knockup, and Unicorns are caught inside the AoE of Misfits. Redemption comes in, keeping Kakao nice and healthy, but it looks like they've run smack dab out of damage in Exile. TPing in, caught out by Kakao, goes back in, chains are on, he's gonna have to walk it out, dodges a Glitter Lance. Unicorns get nobody, but they're low. In comes Alfari, reinforcements have arrived. And no amount of Golden Golden is going to save you, Chachi. Down he goes. Hansama gets one. Power on the chase. Lantern,
ooh,
he's
safe.
Out. They've got four members making their escape right now. But Power does not want to give that up. He has to.
Yeah, really key smoke screen into Smite. Made it so that Xerxe survived. But I don't think he can be back in time to contest, because now this is going to be an incredibly fast dasher, especially once Hansama starts hitting it.
All right, Alfari's full health inside of the pit. Ignar looking to zone around. He throws down the Blue Trinket. A Blue Trinket is thrown down, I should say. This is going too quick. It's going to be picked up by Misfits.
And a really timely engage. At the start of that fight, Visage was overheating, which means his ultimate came out very late. And despite it being a 4v5, look at Chachi overheats now. Instant Arrow comes out, and it's so hard for Unicorns to answer because LeBlanc teleports in, and look how far away Kennen is from this fight.
Also, Exile coming in, 60% HP, and Power of Evil turns instantly, forces him away from the fight. And so when we talk about how Exile can't really do a whole lot against all the shields.
Yeah, Hansama also with some really good kiting and then flash over the wall. He barely survived that fight. Here, Xerxes, let's save my Lantern. I like how Power doesn't overextend here too. Watch how he respects the distance of the Healy Hook. Oh, well, don't watch.
Or don't.
He did it.
800 damage for Exile. Came in with the teleport. Couldn't do much. Had to back away, and there's now a TP gone from him, so Chachi gets to go down to the bottom lane to deal with Afari, but that's not working for the Unicorns of Love.
No, they don't need a banner right now. All the creeps are buffed. Exile looking for a big Xerxes as well. They're trying to shut it down in the start of the split push.
Okay, Exile covers all the distance he can, but Misfits, they're able to back away.
And they can go really heavy on the bot push here, though, the Misfits. Free reign for Afari.
He's going to get that tower 100%. He's got to stop anyone from actually going down to defend him. So a brave call I made there.
Well, Afari is able to do well.
That was a great call. Sometimes I love learning alongside you.
It's just the predictions, you know. The cannon will get
this.
The
blue buff's going to die.
It's already dead, my friend.
Too slow.
Too slow.
You guys want me to like just leave you alone for a minute?
Yeah.
You can watch.
Didn't expect that one, did you, Pyra?
I don't know what to expect anymore. This has been a weird day for sure. Misfits. They are looking to go on in. Kakao baiting with his face.
Exile does more damage to himself when he jumps in than to any of the Misfits members. That is definitely a problem
rough
for
one
him.
For Exile.
It's almost like watching EDG versus SKT at MSI. Counter to fake is LeBlanc. The counter to Exile is LeBlanc.
Lulu.
Doesn't sound as powerful, but...
Yeah.
Also, it was Morgana instead of Lulu, but...
The counter to the German Faker?
Counter to the German, well, who is?
Das Faker?
I think that's what this series was meant to
das Faker.
Show, right?
It's technically probably Der Faker, but...
Isn't that D Faker?
Huh? D Faker? No, there is like...
Listen, the part about German that no one understands is Der, D, Das. You just mix them together and use them at random points.
That's your approach.
Daddy Das, yeah.
Oh, okay. Cool. I'm glad your German lessons are paying off, Deficio. Misfits on the lead right now. They've been able to pick themselves up a dragon, but they weren't able to find a pick onto Xerxes. The arrow didn't go where it wanted to, and Kakao is stopped short. Still, it's a Barwolf phrase. They have the tempo advantage.
Mm-hmm. Had it all game long.
Continuous.
Based on the draft, three pushing lanes. And there was an opening early from Xerxes, but. It really shows the drafting excellence.
We have to remember also Chachi then died right after in the 1v1. Alfari just outplayed him.
Did not help.
They definitely not help. Now, fourth item, you can get your Hurricane as a top lane cannon, which means teamfight cannon is going to be a thing. Still not the greatest, but it works.
Especially if Power people can keep him alive. Double shield, can help this cannon scale, get multiple stuns off.
And keep Ansama alive, keep even Kakao alive. Just keep someone alive. Whoever Exile is on, you just try and keep that guy alive here. And Unicorns of Love really need... They're obviously sitting backstage already kind of thinking, what do we do with Lulu?
We can finally see where Ignar is going to go. Locket or Banner?
He's going to go Locket.
He's going to go Locket, but I do think Banner is still better.
I get it
maybe
with the split
Lulu
push,
build the banner.
But do you even need more split push at this point, or do you just care?
Do you know how long it takes for LeBlanc to tear through like above banner creep on three lanes?
Do you know how long it takes for LeBlanc to kill anyone when there's a Locket as well, shielding them?
But you have a million shields already.
Why not add a million and one? Can you really get too many shields?
Yes.
This game.
No.
Not so sure. Damage?
Is there an item that reduces the amount of shielding? No.
No. Yet.
Yes.
Way to go, Deficio!
Yes! That's how they're gonna counter mid lane Lulu.
Yeah, next
there we go. Well, that's gonna be a ways away. We're still on 7.6. And Unicorns having to take a quick retreat. Kakao wanted to go in, but they stopped Samick short as he flashes away.
Oh, Tigger Cannon!
Right under tower. Power of Evil! That's a big pick! And they're throwing down the damage right now. There was a red carpet out of Visit Chachi, but it was his going away party as he's back to Fountain. Kakao and the rest of Misfits, they found themselves two quick picks.
Yeah. Guy in the card, he gets it, man. He gets it. Lulu mid lane as well from Power of Evil. Such a good pick for him in this game.
Picks on picks on picks for Power. Five members remain on Misfits. Only three stand to fight them on the Unicorns. To quote the great Deficio, this tower is going down.
Xerxes is trying to
defend,
but there's
no
nothing going on.
Maybe
there.
You are wrong.
I don't know. It looks like it may take a second. Meanwhile, Alfari is soloing Exile down on the bottom. This one is all Misfits right now, and they take down Hillisang too.
Rotation coming out. Mid to bot here. Another turret falling.
They're going to be able to get this one, no problem. Misfits are looking to stay alive. It was two Unicorns games. We have had some long ones, but gentlemen, this series is going to continue.
Definitely going to a game four. Is it going to be another reverse sweep?
I don't know, my friend.
To start,
I
mean,
how do you brand
time
yourself?
To adapt now.
How do you brand yourself? If you're a new team in the LCS, you already get to this point. What better way to go into the finals? And with some classic reverse sweeps in a row.
Very true, very true. It would be boring if they just 3-0'd everyone.
Yeah.
Here in Europe, we don't like teams who wins all the time.
With clean macro and slow plays.
No,
blaze.
We don't want to see that. Apparently we want to see crazy fights left and right.
And
so
right
this
series.
Is Unicorns who, I guess, tried to start a fight, but then they realized they didn't actually want to start a fight. And now they don't really have any damage left.
I do like how they play around hooks, though. Like, Misfits are always juking away from the hook channel from Hillisang.
Yeah. Fight over Hillisang going in, though, and then instant flash away. And this is Afari in the bottom lane, together with his good friend Power of Evil. Power of Evil is everywhere.
Yeah, he's doing some serious work this series. And oh, with another Baron 35 seconds away, Misfits, they're looking to close this one, put a lid on the game. Unicorns are not going to go down without a fight.
Yeah. Another classic Unicorns brush.
Oh boy. Oh, Hilly! Who's catching who this time? There they go. There is another big equalizer, but there's a redemption for Misfits here. Teleport is going to get canceled. Alfari is still working his way through the top side. Misfits realize they don't need to take the 5v5.
Playing the split push game right there. Kakao just lurking around. Ooh. Might even be worth canceling back here. Yep. Just
gonna get
make
one.
Him walk.
Oh boy. They might be able to take a 4v5 here. Chachi. He's gonna pop his Zhonya's in Kakao. He's stunned up for just a second. Wild Growth keeping him alive not too long.
Kennen walked to the fight. Alfari was not split pushing. He walked to the fight. He's been conditioned to teamfight Kennen, but he lost his true identity as a split pusher.
Well, now he might die as well. He's gonna trade his life for this tower here.
He's still going for inhib right now. This is risky. Let's even get through the base. I don't know. Chachi's there to cut him off.
I think Alfari was a little lost right there.
Yeah, just a bit. Trying to get the outplay, but it's 1v3. There's no way he's getting through this one. Stopped out.
His team is on Baron, though. Xerxy and Samox are around the Baron. Oh, he gets a kill!
He does it! Alfari gets one back! Oh, that's hashtag worth!
Oh, Nexus turret fell in the process, too. Nashir was started, but stopped. They peeled off. Now Ignite's running. A little bit of chaos here at the end.
I mean, it's just... In the moment, calling can be difficult.
Yes.
The team might be calling for the fight, so he's moving down. Then he realizes there's no point in entering the fight, and he goes back up to the top lane. Open up the base a bit more, which is already a small win. Like, Misfits at this point can afford losing one or two guys here and there.
They also have two Mountain Drakes picked up this time for themselves. Not Unicorns. We've seen a lot of mountains this series.
It's very true. Everyone wants the objective, so this is... Kakao jumping in, and you can see now on your minimap how far you're kind of moving up.
He used Lightning
and
Rush, and then he has to do the Walk of Shame. As Kennen, when you Lightning Rush to get to a fight, and you realize, actually, no, you gotta walk back very slowly.
And they got Matt.
Cheeky little juke here, though.
See, Exile coming in.
I mean, he's still a threat, big
One,
time.
Two, Exile steps out of the ulti, goes in auto attack range again, though.
Ooh, Exile did not respect that damage. Oh.
Baron seems to be the only way Unicorns can get back in this game, and there's really no point in taking a 50-50 Baron if you're Misfits.
Yeah, a lot of recycling going on. Ignar, though. Oh, Hillisang caught again.
He got the banner.
Oh, no. Hillisang is
your
caught.
Banner.
There's the box. He takes a hook to the Krugs, and he's going to make it out. And yes, Deficio, there's a banner of command.
I love this banner pickup by Ignar.
I think it's a great pickup.
I think it's
well.
Intelligent.
I agree. I mean, you can definitely get too many shields.
Yeah.
So I think getting the banner here makes a lot of sense.
Well, really, if you already have a million shields, why get a million and one?
I agree. Like, a million and one makes no difference.
Very close.
You two are shameless. Baron Vision.
We just agreed. That's all.
I'm glad.
Look at that bad boy.
Glad. Yeah.
Look at him push in.
Yep.
Nobody's going to deal. Who's going to deal
That's
with this creep?
That's a big minion.
Auto-attack Rumble.
Auto-attack Rumble.
All right, who wins in a fight? That guy or the Super Creep?
What Super Creep? They're dead.
Yep. Okay, never mind. But you know what else is about to be dead?
That's the kind of information no one actually knows. Like, will a Super Minion kill the Banner of Froth? I'm pretty sure a Super Minion will win.
Like a Super Minion? Yeah.
Oh boy.
But Banner up creeps are dead.
Don't take 50-50. Do not take 50-50.
Step away from the Baron if you're Misfits.
Okay, smart move. Misfits do not opt into that.
Oh, we might get a backdoor.
Oh boy, here goes Alfari. He's got flash, he's got TP. Unicorns are held at bay. There's the
back to Baron, back to Baron. Go, 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 go.
Yeah, back onto it. Full vision right now.
Would love a control ward in that Baron, but okay, they're gonna kill it anyway. Because this actually allows now Unicorns to get some wards in this. The lack of control ward also removes some safety for Misfits.
Unicorns have no way to win this right
Nexus
now.
Turn
this
is falling.
Alfari.
Alfari's gonna do it too, man.
Autos. There's no answer right now. And
they're gonna die.
They're gonna kill him. The back door.
At least four more shots, but he's dying. He's low.
Hold on a sec. He gets a heal.
Nine. His phone.
Oh, man. That was
Chachi. Okay, hold on a minute. Chachi is caught. Rest of Misfits are here, but he's going to get away.
This is actually good for Unicorns.
Good for Unicorns, yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty good for Unicorns.
I don't think they mind.
Oh, if Fire just had a lock.
They have to base Rush Nashor now. That's the only play they can do.
Oh, but yeah, so there's no super minions coming, and they got inhib, so the minions are not going to be an issue.
It literally is base Rush Nashor.
Especially now.
This is very greedy.
Unless Misfits don't want to take a 4v5 at the Baron, they want to just get something in return.
They're going to trade.
All right, Exile, teleport.
All right. Misfits.
So now they can try and fight, maybe. Can they get there in time? That's the question.
Yeah, where's Exile? This is a super slow Nashor. This teleport should have been used already.
Kakao's on the way with Kakao's the Elder coming. Drake.
It's so close.
Here he goes. Can he get in for the steal right now? Just in time. He can't get it, but now the fight is on. Kakao keeping Xersei locked up inside the pit. He pulls the lantern out. He's going to have to flash his way to freedom. Unicorns are making it out with everybody.
Yeah, just need to run away now. They just got Baron. Unicorns above. That was very important to deny that from Misfits. But still, Elder Drake on Misfits, Baron on the Unicorns above. No Nexus turrets.
No Nexus turrets. But Athari is the man to watch right now. He has to make the moves on the split push. And TP advantage. And a banner creep.
Yes, banner to help him. The banner was pretty useless.
But
last
you put
time.
The banner on the other lane. You put it on the Exile lane.
We get it. We're so tired of your banner talk, Rebel. Yeah. It's another thing to add to your list of things you're not allowed to talk about anymore. Yeah. Like bot lane and Crux. And Bard. See, and Bard. No Bard anymore.
It's over. The balance team was so tired of mine.
Please, Kevin, please, let's just remove it. We might actually see a Bard today.
We may.
We're going to have several more games in store for us right now. Misfits can close this one out, but it's looking shakier
it's getting a little bit closer than anticipated.
Yeah, somebody jinxed it in the early game.
I'm pretty sure it was the crowd.
The Unicorns?
So there's no real damage from Power of Evil in terms of like pure burst, but he has a lot of like follow-up damage all the time. Can just kind of move around. He's fairly low cooldowns very easily.
Lich Bane does make sense then on the Lulu.
100%.
Because you're just casting a lot of spell rotations that you will get those auto procs.
But you also really want your death cap now, which is obviously caused what he's building towards, because it helps so much with additional HP and so on for him on his extra spells like shields. Now I just want to see the cooldown. So 6 seconds for him on hill picks, his E. And 4.2 seconds on Glitterland, so fairly low cooldowns. He can move in and out of fights, use them.
Far dealing ton of damage, but he's slower to get through these creeps, obviously. But Baron buff creeps helping a lot.
Banner is ready.
Baron versus Elder, Misfits. They get a catch. Might be able to pull something off here.
Top side lane is pushing out, though. That's the problem. Misfits did not set up their waves very well. Obviously, they don't need it, but it helps if somebody has to deal with that eventually. If only there was a way to slowly push that lane.
Yeah, by walking up there and killing the waves.
I agree.
No one is doing it right now, though. I think we're going to get at least
Ignar's
one.
He's going.
Ah!
He's going to get a buddy.
Oh, Exile's after him. He's following him.
He wants Ignar. There is a lot of movement speed buff. He's not going to catch him.
Yeah, but he's not there to be caught.
Come on, Ignar. You can move in and press the button.
Oh, it's too late. He can't turn around that wave.
Well, use your... at this point,
you don't use it. It dies. You got to do it from the base. That's the bounce. Yeah, Unicorns using this Dasher to put some pressure on the map.
Turning the tables right now. See if they can get this tower down. Han Sama has to respect the Exile damage. Samix takes the Lantern out. That's a lot of damage dealt to that mid-tier.
Yeah, and a division that we had earlier on the top red side, or top right side for Alfari, it's gone right now. So he doesn't feel comfortable split pushing as much. I mean, may actually be watching a turnaround here. The reverse sweep.
That means we will get some of these big late game fights. Chachi, 4 items for him, so he's a man to watch obviously on the Unicorn side in a team fight. Samix as well. If it's not going to be about Exile, it has to be about the 2 other carries. And that's where Samix with this Lucian as well can show up. But he's not been a guy who's been dominating in team fights this split. Pretty decent laning phase, had very good numbers early on. Once again, it's on the bottom side though. They used it
to bait visit Chachi. Banner is so broken.
What a great,
fantastic item. Chachi, he's just delaying the inevitable at this point. Burns his flash. He does touch the arrow. Whoa.
Baby!
I was the one who got juked. Unicorns leave no man behind. And now Misfits, they cannot get a kill.
Oh man, what a nice escape from Mr. Chachi.
Yeah, but he got lured in. He was trying to clear that one last creep.
Hey, he got out though. Mission complete.
He makes it out. Such a bold overcommitment, but somehow he still gets saved here. And these are like game-losing plays if he dies there.
Lost his flash though, which is important in late game fights for him also to get
one
into the back line.
On a mission. Like,
didn't actually even need to kill her there.
No, because he's
gonna die anyway. Yeah, he's gonna die to the minions.
This is gold, man. 58 gold. Economic crisis.
Ah, he's baiting out the redemption.
Hold that juke though. That was sexy.
That was pretty sick.
I mean, this is the thing. This is the trust. Unicorns have the utmost trust in each other. It is a cornerstone of the way they play together, and this is why you can make these plays that sometimes might be mistakes, because you can trust your team's gonna get your back. Chachi got out, and that's a fact.
Can't argue with that. He did get out.
Yeah.
Sadly for him, he did lose his flash, which is, again, a potential problem. Same with Xerxe in their attempt here to save their top laner. Everything on the side of Misfits is available except for teleport for Alfari. So they are ready to fight right now.
But he's grouping.
Well, he has no teleport at this point. Could still obviously go push out a side and then move in. Let's see. Bottom lane right now is pushing for the unit. No, there's a banner down
there's
there.
An arrow.
Oh man, he's been hitting goals.
So bot lane with the banner of command cannon there for Misfits. Top lane is pushing heavy for Unicorns.
And they also have stronger creeps, because the more turrets you take in the lane, the stronger your creeps get.
All right, Chachi, Equalizer, they realize they can turn on this fight, looking for Hansama, but he's already out. Now Redemption is going to keep him alive, but Chachi's a little bit low in this. Kakao turns for Samix, he gets hooked up for just a second, not going to get taken down. Chains were on in the box, disengage. Late. Unicorns get another chance.
Late QSS from Sama, I think he was relying on Kakao taking the hook. Was the hook on Hansama?
No QSS on Hansama here.
Was it Mikhail's then?
Mikhail's came in, yeah, from Ignar, but you can see in these fights how Misfits, they also know a lot of their damage is coming from a very long fight where they survive the engage from Unicorns, and then they get down one of the two squishy members pretty quickly. Xerxes here to take care of the business.
That's
still, because Misfits have like this very slow team fight, auto attack cannon, you know, your Lulu late game now who doesn't provide that much damage. They find Chachi again though, and
yeah, but there's the lantern.
Every time with the lantern. But we got a lot more burst on the side of Unicorns. They just can't really use the burst properly. So we get these really even fights where no one overcommits from Unicorns, and Misfits don't really kill anyone on the other side.
It's a bit of a catch 22.
But then you're going to get the split push.
And then Visichachi being caught 22 times as well.
Getting closer and closer in any case.
Oh, he's baiting out cooldowns.
I'm starting to see why Unicorns value Thresh so much.
Yeah, it's been a very good pick in this game for Hill in terms of the lanterns, at least.
Well, now the Baron is about to respawn. Unicorns were able to trade that real quickly for an Elder right now, and Misfits, they are not keen to give it up this time around.
Yeah, but
it'll
Misfits
be a while before Elder's up.
Seems like they really want to force that Nashor.
Well, there's a Lantern again. Kao, thrill of the hunt. Looking for Xerxe, but just out of range, and he gets hooked right back on in. There's the arrow, connects this time. Alfari in the front, so is Chachi, but the Unicorns are holding stronger. They get one, and that's a 60-second death timer.
Yeah, it looks so good when a cannon slices into five members, pops the ulti, and then realizes,
he's not AP cannon.
I'm not AP, I'm actually not doing any damage. He's not a tank either, so when he dives in like that, Unicorns can actually turn around and kill him, because the follow-up for Misfits, it's not there. It's Lulu, Ashe, Karma. They're sitting in the back line.
And they ran out of shields.
They're not going to go with Alfari. They need to actually kite on the side of Misfits and not dive in with full attack damage and attack speed cannon.
But we see a fight started by Misfits when they have teleport on cannon, which is a mistake. This guy should be on a side lane. And the Unicorns say, thank you very much. And now they pick up another shield. Yeah, one look at.
We're joking around at this point, hope people realize. So, right now, Unicorns get to actually step away from the fight at first. Kao jumps in, and now
look at the force. It's so forced here. They should be on a side lane with this cannon, because look, he goes in and does absolutely mediocre damage, because Visichachi is buying so much time in the backline.
Yeah, Chachi just sitting there in Hourglass. Three guys from Misfits not able to join, and two of those are the AD carry and the mid laner. It's not like support and jungle. It is key members in the late game. They're not looking to dive the back line, and now I'm sure Alfari realizes that as well.
Yeah.
This is the reason everybody gives so much credit to the Unicorns. They're team fighting. They're called the best team fighting team in Europe. They have the experience in all of these unorthodox, crazy situations, and they just keep their calm. They are gunning for a sweep to make it to the finals in Hamburg. These guys have been playoff mainstays, but they haven't made it to this stage in a long time. They're looking to make that different.
They definitely want to make it all the way to the final and challenge G2 for the throne. No boots on Alfari. Tired of that garbage. is an ulti.
There we go. They found Alfari himself. He might be wishing he had boots to step a little quicker this time. But Kakao jumps back in. Unicorns are still able to secure themselves a tower. But can they survive the back half of this fight? They've flown through Kakao's health bar. Misfits are running scared back to base.
Notice how this time Misfits actually managed to step away from the fight first. Hourglass was not used by Visichachi.
Probably polymorphed. Must have been polymorphed.
Most likely. You can see it in the replay. But this was much better kiting from Misfits. Sadly, then they actually re-engage and lose Kakao.
But one thing we saw from Misfits is that their shot calling becomes very erratic in the late game. A lot of people yelling. And Kakao, I think, bought into the hype of the 4v5. He ran forward head first into culling. And he just got bopped for no reason. And now this is his smite versus no smite. Hillisang super aggressive here.
Yeah, maybe they can turn the fight on. Alfari, though, he's able to tank through. And Hillisang is going to get taken down. Now it's a 4v3. And the rest of Unicorns are getting shut down.
Hillisang!
The power of evil flashes in.
He's still going right now. Power wants to chase on. The arrow is going to get flashed. Oh, man. Misfits.
There are no minions.
Backdoor, it can end.
Well, they're at least going to try and get this in here. Noted, Visichachi's alive in 1 second, and there's no minions. But there's, of course, no Nexus.
There's no Nexus.
They can win.
That's what I said. They can win.
They're going to win.
One inhibitor, they got it down.
I think there's Nexus towers.
They're trying to defend.
They're not going
to
win.
Oh, man, this is going to be the last chance. Salute.
Power's all
posted. They're not going to win.
She comes up big. They're turning it right around.
Asama.
Inspiration move at 48 minutes.
They're going to win. They're going to win.
Misfits are going to do it. It's a double kill. Nexus, put on your dancing shoes, because Misfits are staying alive!
It's been such a long time since we were near the Nexus. Those turrets died long time ago.
There were no minions.
Long time ago, but there was a Visit Chachi. Chachi left alive, but did manage to win the fight. What a turnaround. It was looking like Unicorns of Love were straight back in the game. And then Hillisang.
We got ourselves a series, boys. Oh,
yeah,
this
we
is
do.
So good.
Woo. I mean,
hi.
Hello. Yes. Hello, once again. We're still here.
We were not jumping around.
No, definitely not getting excited.
I just need like Banner of Command.
So the Banner, it made sense.
So was the Lulu mid.
Wasn't the big thing for them in the end. It was the fact that they didn't have any Nexus turrets.
Yeah, that is definitely a way to lose the game when you don't have Nexus turrets.
I mean, try and analyze this bad boy, though. A lot of things happened.
Well, we'll get to that in a minute anyways. But, I mean, Misfits, backed against the wall, part two. They take a game.
I think the draft was really smart. This side lane cannon, once cannon was in the side lane, we could really see Unicorns were on lockdown. They just made a few errors in execution, but the early game was definitely controlled on Misfits. So this Lulu will not see play anymore into the LeBlanc. No way that makes it to the second ban phase.
No, but that obviously means that it might be actually Misfits getting a LeBlanc pick on their side. Yeah. Potentially
also,
as the last pick on red side and then ban on Ryze.
And they may not have to ban it themselves, because if you haven't played this match...
Yeah, surely he hasn't. Practice Lulu.
Yeah, else he would know.
Yeah, else he would obviously know.
But is he bold enough to play it first time on stage?
I mean, some of the players in Europe, they do like to you a first time, different champions, even in playoffs.
Yeah, we've seen that a couple of times this playoffs.
The Vayne is an example, kind
one
of popped
them.
Out of nowhere, but no. That's Power of Evil. He gets the Lulu.
Yeah.
I think Exile will get the Ryze on his side if it is a trade.
Yeah.
But Misfits probably don't have to trade the LeBlanc at all, as they will have most likely last pick for mid.
Yeah, you can see a post-game discussion right there in Power.
Between two members.
Yeah. Man on your screen was very, very influential, but we've heard from Hussein how impactful his discussions are for the team, how they're able to turn things around. I mean, there's so much insight in that behind the reverse sweep video, and I think there's a lot more to come. We'll see as we look to keep this series going. Misfits came back against Splice. They want to do it again. Let's see what the analysts have to say about all that.
Hello, Pyra. This guy is still playing so hard. It's hilarious to see. As the game progressed, he's like, oh no, we have to talk about this again. But super interesting game because it just turned completely on its head at the end. And I want to start by the final replay is where the Misfits eventually do get it. Stress, what makes it's Unicorns being over-aggressive, no?
So I think the plan there is Hilly says, okay, if somebody like Parabule or Han Sama comes forward alone, they hook him, they get the kill. That's the play they're looking for, but they don't need to look for that play. They've already kind of got the Elder Dragon at half health, but all they have to do here is not lose a fight, and they end up winning the game. They had the Baron buff, but Hilly gets caught, they lose a bunch of members, and then they've got no Nexus Towers. Even with the backdoor prevention on and the fact that Misfits are just working with no minions, it doesn't matter because Hans Sama, Power of Evil have so much damage between them and Alfari that it's an easy close.
Yeah, I think we should need like a freeze frame as Misfits is going to contest that Elder Dragon to like, well, you're probably wondering how I ended up in this position because I shouldn't have been there in the first place. Let's talk, well, when this plays out, we can talk about the mid game, but we'll just see them crushing it and killing the Nexus because there's no Nexus turrets left. There we go.
We really have to praise the solo laners of Misfits this game. It kind of reminds me a little bit of our series that Misfits have like individuals that steps up when it really matters. And in this game, it was Alfari and Power of Evil who both solo kills their lane opponents. And it really gives Misfits a huge advantage in the early game that they can play off. And those guys are the guys who carried them through.
They did. Caps, are your eyes opened? Lulu as the counter to LeBlanc.
I'm not so sure about like... I mean, it used to be a counter, right? The Lulu to LeBlanc, or at least people used to like playing it into LeBlanc. But I'm not sure how much of this is Lulu being the new broken pick, or and how much if it's just the exile. I'm not sure if I want to say not respecting his opponent, but I think it's
trolling.
More that he just... No, I don't know. It's not trolling, because I think he just doesn't know Lulu's limits. I think he has never played before against a Lulu before.
I mean, he's never played versus a Lulu before, mid or bottom laner, or is that different just
no, a Lulu mid lane.
Yeah.
Yeah, we have to remember that Power of Evil is also a guy who played a lot of Lulu. Like, when you have, back in the days when you played OG, when you have a guy like OG Nils and you pick Lulu, you basically know that it's almost a free win at this point. So he definitely played a lot of Lulu in the past, so he should know about the champion.
He should. Well, but it worked now, and that also opens up a lot of things. Do they have to ban it out now for the next one or not? I do also want to take a look at another fight, though. Late game team fight where the Unicorns of Love near turn the game back around. So what happens here? Someone.
I mean, basically, Kakao goes too deep. He gets really chunked. And then Misfits kind of needs to use all their ults on Kakao instead of using it for their carries. And then the fight is not played as well. They want to kind of stay around the Ashe. And make sure that Ashe is kind of the front line with these picks they have, because it should be so hard for UL to actually kill the Ashe. But instead they get the fight and they get the Baron, and then at that point UL is actually really in a good spot, because the way Misfits want to play the game is have Kennen on the side lane and pressure the Rumble, but now Rumble can group up with the team and they can force us five, and that's where they are strong.
Caps, is this something in playing versus Unicorns as well? You guys have noticed that they're just really good at hanging on, and because they're good at team fights, they find ins in games that they should be out of long for then.
Yeah, it's like it happens a lot in scrims where usually teams will either forfeit or they will just... they'll just slowly lose when you start getting a lead. But Unicorns, they will just like run it down mid lane, look for a fight. They'll just go on you, and sometimes you're not prepared for it because you're thinking that you're thinking about how you want to close out the game, and then suddenly they are just fighting you, you know?
Yeah, definitely. We see them here hanging on as well. But we talked a lot about the Unicorns. We got to talk about the Misfits. Is it happening? They put it all on the solo laners. And I remember when they turned it around versus you guys, they put it all on, they had the Kalista Thresh bottom lane that they picked kind of out of nowhere. And they completely turned it around based off individual performances as well. So is it starting to tilt?
By now, like,
we know the script.
The next couple of games, you will see Power of Evil playing LeBlanc, and then we know what happens. And
yeah. Stress in the beginning of the day said, if you want to put all your eggs in the one basket, 3-0 for Unicorns. Ha! Where is your god now? Or where are your eggs now? Definitely not there.
I guess that's like the saying right there, right? That's what happens.
Yeah. No. On a more serious note, Misfits, they now are one game back in there. So how big is kind of the experience that the Misfits have that they've done it last week? You know they can do it. Up versus the Unicorns, though, who are a team that they've been through everything. They've been through game fives, reverse sweeps, Nexus holds and reholds. Like, what wins out here?
I think that the Unicorns right now can kill that momentum by doing something, not necessarily a bit different, but throw a bit of a curveball from what we've seen in the games up until now. Whether it's a different bot lane combination, maybe it's not the Lucian for Samux, maybe it's a mid lane pick that Exile is very comfortable on, again, like the Vladimir or the Ryze of the casters we're talking about. Something that's a little bit different, and I think Misfits won't just try and play the same stuff again and again. Force Misfits to adapt again, and don't let them play this style with strong solo laners.
Also, maybe removing the LeBlanc might be a good option for them, because it seems like Misfits got a couple of picks that they're comfortable playing into it. So maybe just banning it away and see how the mid matchup will go by then, and probably not end up in the Vlad Ori matchup again. I don't feel like that was that good for them.
Okay, well, we will see what happens. Misfits, they have not given up on the series yet. Game 4 is coming up after the break.